my cabinet colleague, Pona Radhakrishnanji. Second cabinet colleague, Mansukh Bhai, Hamare, he is also minister for pharmaceuticals and fertilizers, state minister. And Pona Radhakrishnanji, also state minister for finance. And at the same time, he is for road ministry, is a state minister. And he is also state minister for shipping and ports. All respectable dignitaries on the dais, and our MP from Vishakhapatnam, Hari Babuji, and Karyakarta, dear friends and sisters. Andhra Pradesh most important issue is Polavaram. Many times lot of people from the party, from the other parties and the state government every time meeting me. I understand the importance of water. If anyone asks me a question, which is the crucial issue in the country, I always say water is a crucial issue, water is a big problem. I am from Maharashtra, part of Vidarbha, where we have more than 10,000 farmer suicides. It is only because of lack of irrigation. The most important thing is, under the leadership of Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji, first time we have taken decision to finance the state irrigation projects. Because as far irrigation is concerned, it is in the state list. So Pradhan Mantri Sichai Yojana is the first scheme where our government has taken a decision. The project we have already completed works more than 50%, we will finance them. And for that purpose, we are selected 108 projects and we are giving them 25% grant from Government of India and 75% as a loan from NABARD. So by this way, we are now creating the irrigation facility in our government, where first time the central government is allocating funds to the state government. This is first time in the history of India. Up till now, many times the state government demanded, but never central government financed the irrigation projects. The second thing is, the river connectivity project is also one of the historical and important projects. Now only take the example of Godavari. 3,000 TMC of water is going to the sea. And here we are facing the water problem. The Congress party, the previous government, never think about it. It is the first time in the history of country, Atal Bihari Vajpayee planned the river connectivity program. And now, for the first time, in my own department, out of 30 schemes, we have completed all formalities related to the 6 teams, and now 2 days before I signed the file, and now it is going to the cabinet approval. Now the most important thing is that we are already giving full finance for Polavaram. It is a national project. When there was division between Andhra and Telangana, it was decided that we will treat as a national project and the cost of construction for this project will be the responsibility of the federal government. So this is our responsibility to complete this project. Now yesterday I visit Polavaram. I take the review for 2 hours of every problems, land acquisition, utility shifting, particularly the RRR rehabilitation. And at the same time, I also examine the civil engineering construction, and I get lot of information, and I declare there that any cost, we have to complete this project, only civil engineering part of the project, before February end. Now, it is really a great responsibility. Work is moving fast, and government is giving finance for that. But there are some problems. One of the problem is at the time when the DPR is prepared, in the previous government, the project started from 1941. And after that, when YSR was the chief minister, the DPR was prepared, and then still there was no work. The first time after Modi ji taken charge as the prime minister, our government has given money and we start this work. So this is the most important thing for the Bharatiya Janata Party and for the federal government, that we have taken a decision to start this work. Now, as far as this work is concerned, now at the time when the land acquisition requirement was planned in the DPR, now that acquisition is more than double. So technically, yesterday we verified the things, and now we have appointed WAPCOS in my own department as a consultant agency to verify the facts. At the same time, there are a lot of land involved in this project belongs to scheduled tribe, and we are very cautious and sensitive about it. Already I have suggestion given to state government that it is our responsibility that we should give a better life to the people, particularly for scheduled tribes, and we are planning for that. And the first thing which I want to assure you, whatever the money we need, but we will make a very, very sustainable development of the tribal people, giving them land, employment, housing, and all type of education facility, health services, skill development centers. And already I have issued my instruction to the state government that they will be benefited from this project. The second important thing is, as far as the act passed by the central government in 1914, so now it is a problem that because of that the land acquisition cost is increased. So I also admit that it is a response to the government that we will find out the solution for that. Technically the land acquisition is a problem where I already give them suggestion that if we can make some compound wall somewhere, and by which if we get possible for us to save the cost, to technically just verify and find out whether it is possible or not. And the most important thing is, in this project, regarding the civil engineering cost also, there is escalation. And this escalation is because the cost which was already planned, that is the old cost. So in the present DSR, we have to find out what is the cost of the project. There is a lot of changes because the present previous DPR was not perfect. We have to add scope of work in this project, and that is one of the reasons that the escalation is there. We are very transparent, we are corruption free, time bound and quality conscious. In my own department, the road ministry, the shipping, water resources, we have, in my own department only, we crossed the limit of 10 lakh crores. So we have awarded a lot of contracts. But never any contractor, even he don't need to come to me to meet me in Delhi. Because majority of the contractor from Andhra Pradesh, you can ask to anybody. No corruption. So they come, they never come to me and never meet me. So our approach is transparent, qualitative, time bound, result oriented. And that is the reason that we are very cautious about it. The second important thing is, now this is the one of the important and historical project. The 20 meter depth for concrete construction is the first time in the world. So there are a lot of things, even comparing with the other project also, the first time we are making this project. Now I am confident that this project is giving really a good life. It's a lifeline of Andhra Pradesh. That's the reason that people are making follow for that. And to complete this lifeline and giving relief to the people of Andhra Pradesh is the responsibility of Bharatiya Janata Party, Modi ji and myself. So I am going to fulfill 100%. I have got a track record. I am not a minister like that. No media people can ask me about my declaration from last 35 years. I understand what I mean, what I declare, and it's my response to complete it. The February end is not my declaration. It's my target to give it to the contractor. It is a very difficult task. The project is very high. We will try our level best to make it before February end, the civil construction part. For the land acquisition and for RR, it will take some time.
But by this completing this dam, we can stop the water. The second important thing is today I am only talking about the Polavaram and irrigation, and tomorrow I will discuss about the shipping and roads. Now, the most important thing is, in the 6 project which I have already selected as a river connectivity project, there is one important project is related with the Godavari. Now, in Telangana we have a Kaleshwar dam. The cost of the dam is 70,000 crore. And after Kaleshwar, the river name as Indravati coming to there. And Indravati is full of water. So now we have decided, the one line is Indravati excess water is available in Godavari. That is the first thing. And second thing is the backwater of Polavaram. The plan is to taking that water into Krishna, Krishna to Pennar, and Pennar to Kaveri. And we have planned the project in the way that the water will go to the tail end of Tamil Nadu. This our project is costing more than 50,000 crores. And this is the river connectivity project, and by which we can save at least 700 to 800 TMC of water. And this is very important. This is additional to Polavaram. So this is not Polavaram, whatever the water we are taking it and using it, that is the first part. And the second part of this 50,000 project is really very important for Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Tamil Nadu, Pondicherry and Karnataka. This project is going to solve the issue of dispute between Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. The quarrel is only for 35 and 40 TMC. And where we are adding 700 to 800 TMC of water into Kaveri. There is one dam, Somashila, I am not remembering, Somashila is one of the dam. Other is Nagarjuna Sagar. So somewhere we are taking water to Nagarjuna Sagar, then Somashila, to two places we are pumping that water. And the project at DPR is ready. And we are now given this proposal for the cabinet approval. I feel that these two projects, these are the important projects for Andhra Pradesh also, for Telangana also, for Tamil Nadu also, for Karnataka also. And I feel that this is going to solve the problem of South India. This is very historical, and at the same time we are taking two projects in Maharashtra and Gujarat. That is, one is Daman Ganga Pinjar, the other is Tapi Nar Narmada. The other project is between Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. That is in the part of backward area of Bundelkhand. That is also a very important project. And there are also 3 projects are there. And we have decided to raise finance for this project. This is very important. Already we have 108 project. We are giving this project which are completed 50% work. We are financing them. And now we are planning to, in place of canal, we will use the pipeline, and by pipeline we are using drip irrigation. So by which we can save the water and save the cost for land acquisition. And by drip irrigation we can increase the productivity by 2.5% and use of water by 3 times. This is also very important. Now the problem is that water is available, but the agriculture production, huge production, is also one of the big problem for the country. Once upon a time, it was shortage of food grain was our problem. Today, the surplus of food grain is a problem. So that is the reason that we are facing problem, but our Prime Minister has taken a decision to give 1.5 times prices more than MSP. And this is also a great challenge. I request you, particularly for the people, farmers of Andhra Pradesh, that we are importing 70% edible oil. So now it is the time for the farmers to get more oil seed production. The palm oil is also one of the, we are importing from Malaysia. We are now charged 40% duty on it. And that is when the palm oil price is now increased. At the same time in Maharashtra, Gujarat, somewhere there is a, we have soya bean, sarsu, all different type of oil seeds. In Rajasthan we are also, olive is there. So first of all, in Andhra Pradesh, we need to give priority for oil seeds. The second important thing is the subject which is from last many days, 10 years, I am fighting for that. And that is the, I am also a farmer. We are running 3 sugar mills. So the sugar mill also a big problem. We have 60 lakh ton of sugar surplus is with us. That is also a big problem. So now we have decided, we are making, there is a 4% molasses from the sugar per ton. Now we have decided to make heavy molasses. It means that there will be 6% molasses in 1 ton of sugar cane, B heavy molasses, where we are diverting sugar to molasses and by which we can make ethanol. So now the policy is clear, we are giving good rates. Rates are increased. Then by B heavy molasses also, the petroleum ministry is giving good rate. The second thing is we are now decided to making ethanol from cotton straw, wheat straw, rice straw and bagasse. Here we need to convince the people because we have 8 lakh crores we are spending for import of crude oil. Our basic priority for the country and for the government, for the Prime Minister is diversification of agriculture towards energy and power sector. 1 ton of rice straw giving 280 liters of ethanol. The technology is available. From any biomass, cotton straw, wheat straw, rice straw, bagasse, we can make bioethanol. And in my own city in Nagpur, we have 55 air-conditioned buses, luxury buses running on 100% bioethanol. The buses is from Scania. Now we are planning going for trucks, going for tractors, using the fuel which is manufactured by the farmer. So the second generation ethanol is from cotton straw, wheat straw, rice straw and bagasse. And the second important thing is, by segregated municipal waste, by which metal, glass and plastic, also segregated, then we can get the waste, organic waste, where we can make ethanol from that. So that can be a good source. And the third is making ethanol from corn and food grain. Government has given permission by passing the cabinet note now, the rice cut, they are not getting good rates. We can convert that rice cut into bioethanol. This is third generation ethanol. The fourth important decision is taken by the government, even as a shipping minister we are doing, making methanol from coal. We have got some part of the Andhra Pradesh, we have got the coal. And we can make methanol from that. And in the international market, the rate of methanol is 70 rupees per liter, equal to diesel rate is 60 rupees per liter. In China, in USA, in Israel, they have a methanol economy. They are running their truck and buses on methanol. So as a transport minister, we have taken a decision. We have Assam Petroleum Company manufacturing methanol. And RCF and Deepak Fertilizer in Mumbai also, they are manufacturing methanol. So we have decided the pilot project of 10 buses, the Mercedes and Volvo, they have a technology of buses on methanol. So 10 buses in Mumbai and 10 buses in Guwahati, we have decided to running on methanol. Now methanol convert into DME, and the DME is a gas. USA, they are adding DME into LPG 20%, so we can reduce the cost of gas cylinder by 50 rupees, and it is indigenous. So basically our policy is import substitute, cost effective, pollution free and indigenous. We are moving to our electric cars, electric buses, electric bikes, and I am the transport minister, and you just say within 6 months, you will see everywhere electric car, electric buses and electric, even tractor also. So my suggestion is, we are changing the total philosophy of transport sector. We are going to reduce import. 8 lakh crores, I am working group in charge in cabinet, and always discussing with the agriculture minister. My dream is at least 2 lakh crores of this petroleum economy we are going to divert to the agriculture. It creates more jobs. Even in Andhra Pradesh and country, we can start 1,000 projects converting biomass into ethanol. The rice straw is available. In the part of Delhi, near to Delhi, it's named as Parali, and they are burning And the basic reason for pollution in Delhi because the farmers are burning this rice straw, name as Parali. So my request is, in your country now the irrigation is increased. So the rice production is going to increase. Wheat production may be going to increase. Corn production is going to increase. The biomass will be available. So it is the first time for the farmers to formulate, we already formulated the policy, that conversion of biomass into ethanol. At least in country, we can start 1,000 industry on that basis. This 1,000 industry means creating 250 to 300 direct employment, and by collection of biomass is going to create employment for 5,000 people per industry. So the 1,000 industry is going to create jobs for 40 to 50 lakh people in the rural area. And here is the, our government policies giving more priority for development of agriculture and rural sector. So this is really will be a game changer plan. So I feel that I am also involved on this policy matter. The petroleum minister is with me, agriculture minister is with me, and our dream is import substitute. The 8 lakh crores of this crude oil taking from all Arab countries, at least we have to save 2 lakh crores from that and giving that money to the agriculture. So these are the important issues where our government is concentrating. We have increased the MSP price 1.5 times, and because of mechanism, I am confident that we will give good remunerative prices to the farmers. Now the problem is that we reduce the prices of fertilizer. My colleague fertilizer minister is here. The first time in the history we are giving neem coated urea, and that is, there is no black market for urea, no lottery charge for urea. In the Congress regime, UPA regime, there was lottery charge, but thanks to our minister, now today everywhere the fertilizer is available, and now we have reduced the prices of fertilizer. So really it is a great achievement. We have to reduce the production cost, reduce the petroleum, the diesel cost. We are planning for that. In Kakinada they are making diesel, biodiesel, and I am taking that diesel to Nagpur and giving it to the farmer for the tractor. Now that biodiesel I am using there, so my feeling where there's 2 rupees less rate. Now this is the time that we are now planning to give at least 5 rupees per liter less diesel to the tractors. I am working on that scheme. So my suggestion is, now agriculture is the priority for the government. We are giving a new vision for the agriculture. Water management, drip irrigation, availability of water, and otherwise the fertilizer cost we are going to reduce. We are giving organic farming priority. We are giving priority for food processing. We are exporting agriculture product, and today in my review meeting I have given instruction to all ports, don't give only information about the petroleum export and import. I need now, you should give the priority for blue economy, the export of seafood, export of fruit, vegetables. Make a special arrangement on every port that farmers will be benefited, and it is easy for them to export their fruits and vegetables to whole world. Now in my state, in Nasik, we are exporting 2,000 crores of grapes from Nasik and 1,200 crores of onion from Nasik. Now in Ratnagiri, Alfonso, I was in South Korea. There was Amba Mahotsav. Marathi mein name is the Amba, mango. And the Amba Mahotsav in South Korea. Now we are exporting this mango to whole part of the world. So now this is the time for the farmers and the people we have, that how we can plan export of agriculture. So we are concentrating on that. So today what my feeling is, the water is the important. Without that we cannot develop agriculture. But not only water, we need drip irrigation. We are giving priority for that. We are not going to acquire the land for canals, and we are giving priority for drip irrigation. The result will be 2.5 times more production. But now we have to think seriously about the crop patterns. As far as the world economy is concerned, global economy is concerned, now the rates are not in our hand. The sugar price is decided in Brazil. The soybean oil price is decided in Argentina. The palm oil price is decided in Malaysia. So today, these are the factual things. So we have to decide our crop pattern on the basis of whatever the results in the world economy. What are the prices of the commodity? On the basis of that, we have to decide our crop pattern. It is very important. Agriculture is very important. And I know that the people of Andhra Pradesh are known for productivity. Even in our area, in Nagpur district, some of the farmers coming from Andhra Pradesh, in the Ramtek area, they have a huge production of rice because they are very expert. So my appeal to the all workers, whatever the innovative policy and decision taken by the central government, whatever the decision where we are supporting for the polar work, whatever the decision we are making highways, whatever we decision we are taking making aims, you are the main conductor. You are the most important people who can take all these good achievements of our government to the people. And that is the most important responsibility with all of our karyakarta. This Polavaram, which is a lifeline of Andhra Pradesh, it is a great present to Andhra Pradesh from BJP government, from Modi ji. First time, we are spending 1,000 crores of rupees on this project because we understand it is a lifeline of Andhra Pradesh. Some of the people interpreted that we are politicalizing this issue. We are not going to politicalize. Today I declare the development is different and politics is different. The duty of the Prime Minister, I know that there are only 2 MPs belongs to BJP. But our country, the Andhra Pradesh, is also the part of India. Alag bhasha, alag vesh, phir bhi hamara ek desh. Kashmir hoya Guwahati, apna desh apni maati. We are not taking decision on the political discretions. We are taking the decision on the basis of ground reality. We have a dream is to make this society free from hunger. And we are believe that sabka saath, sabka vikas. No discrimination on political basis, caste basis, religion basis, creed basis, language basis. We are all part and parcel of the society. We are known as Bharatiya, Indian. That is our identity. This is the philosophy of BJP. And that is the reason that we'll never make any discrimination with any state. I am giving a lot of thing to Kerala. We don't have a single MP in Kerala. But we never discriminate. When the chief minister belonged to CPM coming to me with his problem, I always positive to try to solve his problem. Because we don't play politics in the development. Don't want to mix up with it. And that is the reason that you less assured about it. And let us create a confidence in the mind of the people of Andhra Pradesh that we will not politicalize the issue of Polavaram. We will do all the things, whatever the thing need, not on the political basis, but on the ground relative basis that Andhra Pradesh is the part of the country. Polavaram is not the important and historical and prestigious project for Andhra Pradesh, but Polavaram is a prestigious project for the country. And that is the feeling in the mind of the people. All of us, we are working on the same line. So my request is to propagate our feeling and go to the people and give them the whatever the achievement of Modi ji's government. There are hundreds of things with us. Whatever the 50 years of the Congress party and 4 or 5 years of Modi ji, you can make the comparison between it. Now it's not time for me to give every details about it, but you are the best judges, you know that. And now I am expecting from you that you should have this all information ready with you. You take it and take it to the last man of the society. Convey him that we will never discriminate the developmental matters. We are committed for the development of Andhra Pradesh. We are committed for the development of farmers of Andhra Pradesh. We want to create employment potential in Andhra Pradesh. And we see that Andhra Pradesh will be one of the important developmental state in the country. And that is basically, it's not only related to one party. It's not the response of one party. It is not the claim of one party. It is the as a BJP as whole. We are committed for that. And as a federal government, not only that we are talking all these things, but actual on the grassroots level, we are giving resources. We are trying our best to do it. And that is the most important example is of Polavaram. The cost of the project is very high. There are a lot of problems. And as my ministry, I am constantly pursuing this matter. I am always positive to solve the issues because we are committed for the people of Andhra Pradesh. So my request is the politics is different, development is different. And our government is very seriously working on it. The direction of Prime Minister is very clear. So I am confident that let us you take all this our success story to the common people of Andhra Pradesh, and this is the responsibility of the party workers. Today we have 2 days review meeting with the ports. We are discussing the issues. Even the Visakhapatnam port is doing good job. Today we have discussed a lot of issue about Visakhapatnam. In the road sector, we have sanctioned a lot of projects. Even the TDP member of parliament coming to me, I sanctioned the proposals. We don't play politics on it. But I feel that we are working, we are giving resources, but for credit for party, now it is up to you to take the properly this all issue to the common people and convey them that this is the federal government's contribution for the Andhra Pradesh, and I'm expecting your cooperation for that. Once again, I'm giving you all my thanks and best wishes to all of you. Yesterday, also I will apologize for that, because the Polavaram, I come at night 11 o'clock. And just a minute. Regarding the just a minute. आप बाद में बात करिए. Regarding the land acquisition and RR, we have just received the deputation. I am very much cautious about it. I am personally having the monitoring all the things. I have given all instruction to the concerning commissioner and collectors yesterday. I have discussed this all in details. Let's assure about it, and we will complete this project. Once again, I am giving my all thanks to you. Thank you very much. Namaskar.
Bharat Mata Ki.